of viewers, I thought I'd try something a little different this video, and I was going to walk you through the process of this and the inspiration. You can see in the corner that there's a pair of kitty cats, and I'll get to them in a bit, but I am mostly kind of going over some notes here from the stream, and kind of sketching out a couple of very quick thumbnails for the painting itself on some really old paper of mine. And I think here I'm getting into my materials. I'm choosing between two different types of paper and talking about my mannequin for some reason. But, so I started with a non-photo blue pencil. You can definitely see it in the scan when I get to that. But I'm mostly just working with a 6H and then a 2H and 6B lead. And 6H is one of the hardest levels of lead, or graphite is, I think, the most common material used nowadays. And harness basically means if you apply an even pressure, which you would want to use a light amount of pressure, because I can't tell you how many of my sketchbook pages I have dented beyond repair applying so much pressure with heavier leads. But it's hardness to softness is your light mark making to your darker mark making, but your soft leads also tend to be the ones that smudge a bit more, which is why I have that glove down there. And so here I was mostly just trying to pencil this out using a harder lead and hopefully making sure it didn't smear when I got into the wet media portion of it all. And I tried erasing some of the blue lines, which were mostly my wireframes, like my basic shapes and the circles and everything. And this was in between getting it scanned in, looking at the computer, kind of redlining stuff. And at this point I am using a 6B, and you can see how the lines are really starting to come out now. But we will be getting to watercolor here. I applied a little liquid frisket for the eye highlights. I actually messed up there and just applied some more real quick. And I don't know if it's the age of my stuff, because it was sitting in the basement for a few years, but it definitely was a lot tackier than I feel like it should have been. But basically, so now I'm getting my colors together. I have been trying to recycle some of my colors that I have used in the past to just kind of experiment, and I am happy with myself that I decided to try to actually see how the color will look on the paper itself before actually applying it. I had this really bad habit when I was much younger and less experienced with wet media to apply watercolor without really watering it down, and then I would wonder why it didn't last me at all. And I've been watching a lot of people on YouTube now to try to figure out how to do it. So what I've been doing here is I would apply some color and then maybe like add a little more to get more of the shape around, or apply some water to really move it around without it being too heavy in a single area, which I also noticed people were doing for softer edges in watercolor, and I feel like that actually kind of came out pretty good here. But I think now's an okay time to start talking about where the inspiration for this came from. And the two cats in the corner are actually a pair of, I think one is still a stray because she's super shy, but the other does have a collar on her, so she has been taken in. But they're all white, and I think I've seen her mother running around, because this one's bigger than these two. But so I met the bigger one night. I saw that I accidentally got some black in the ones here. The larger one will come right up to anybody, and she's super affectionate, and she will demand all of the pets. And it wasn't until the next day that her sister, we're assuming they're sisters, was kind of hiding in a nearby tree, like, is everything okay? And she would come up eventually, and she was also just as affectionate. And we were really amazed by that. Like, we already have a dog and a cat, so unfortunately we couldn't take them in ourselves. But we would leave food and water out for them, and we considered making cat shelters. But I noticed right away that they had flip-flopped blue and gold eyes, and it's just so beautiful on the two of them. And then reading in deeper, like reading online later, that there's a tendency for them to be deaf, and it's usually in the blue eye. I actually messed that up sketching these, because I wanted them to originally be positioned similarly to this, but the deaf eye be on the inside side, like they're listening for each other. But it could also be this cute thing where they're listening to each other instead of for each other. And we spent some time with them and we saw the eyes, and I just felt compelled to make this illustration. And it's been a very long time since I've had sort of that internal demand on it. And I originally wanted to put them in kimono, but I'm like, no, I put too many things in kimono, so I made them these dresses instead. And here I finally line out some lines in their eyelashes in a really watered down black. It was my own fault, because I didn't realize how black or dark some of the lines would be, and I'm still kind of annoyed with myself about that. But I had also gotten the background in while I was waiting for some of their broader areas to dry. Sorry about that. And then here I'm using a rubber cement eraser to take out the frisket. I did wish that their eyes could have had some more depth to them, but I'm also really happy with the result. I think this is the first time something has actually come out the way I pictured it in my head, and that makes me really happy. And I'm hoping to stream more like this eventually or later. I'm still trying to figure out my lighting situation, but I didn't realize I'd be able to talk over all this, but thank you very much for watching, and stick around for my material list, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.